Hello everybody and welcome to this channel. On this episode I'm going to share with you the history of rose water, one of the most popular souvenirs of my hometown Cauchon, and its production methods that in turn attract many tourists to this place. So stay tuned. Rosewater procedures were invented by Iranians about 1000 years ago. Some parts of Iran have an appropriate climate for planting the Damask rose. Rosewater was one of the main commodities that have been exported to other countries through Silk Road. About 400 years ago, when Safavid dynasty was ruling over Iran, rosewater and its paraphernalia were exported to other countries as well. Ibn Sina, who was a famous Iranian scientist, spent many years of his life to find a way for extracting the essence of Damask rose. Nowadays, Qamsar district in Kashan city is the most dominant place for making rosewater. In this district, each year about 15,000 tons of rosewater is produced and exported to other parts of the world. The best time for harvesting the Damask roses is April 21st until May 21st. And the region for plantation must have productive soil plus cool weather, which means that the area has to receive a lot of precipitation during autumn and winter seasons. When the flower buds opened, farmers wait for a few days and the picking process begins. I should mention that the production of rosewater is done by two methods, including traditional and modern. In the traditional way, we have a giant pot to contain the flowers, a giant lid to cover the pot, a special mixture made of clay and bread paste to fill the holes and open spaces between lid and pot, and some tubes that are a connection between the pot and giant pitcher. In modern method, these equipment are voluminous and each pot can take about a ton of damask rose, which in turn it produces a large amount of rose water. If you want to distinguish the original rose water from fakes, you can taste them and swallow your saliva 2 times. If you still taste the bitterness in your mouth the second time, it means that the rose water is fake and chemical materials have been added to it. Rose water has therapeutic features. For example, in the past, it has been used as a painkiller. Sometimes it was prescribed to treat indigestion, but nowadays people use it to make food aromatic. Rose water is also being used in sacred places to make them fragrant. In general, there are 2 kinds of rose water that are being produced, which are light and heavy. Light rose water is created when we add 20 kilograms of damask rose to the pot plus 80 liters of water, that in the end we will have 40 liters of light rose water. But when we add 35 kilograms of damask rose to the pot plus 80 liters of water, then we will have 40 liters of heavy rose water. Keep in mind that if you want to preserve the rose water for a long time, you have to keep it in glass colorful dishes to avoid it having a chemical interaction with plastic materials. Always keep the rose water in the refrigerator to be away from sunlight and remain in a cool place. After each time that you use some of the rose water, you have to put the lid back to prevent the liquid from interacting with oxygen. The expiration date of this product is up to 1 year. After that, rose water will lose its pleasant smell. If you ever decided to visit Kashan, don't forget to put Amsar district on your itinerary and drop by the 2 rose water factories, both the modern and traditional one, and buy some of their products. If you want to know how the rose water is produced from scratch, I can tell you that at the beginning of the process, farmers plant the seeds in productive soil and use compost and water the seeds until they grow. The plantation starts in mid-March and it takes a month for a flower to blossom. Then farmers commence picking the flowers and collecting them. Next, they are transported to factories. As I mentioned before, there are two kinds of factories for making rose water. In the traditional one, flowers are put into the pot and we add water to them. The pot is placed above a stove, and when we put the lid back and seal it tightly, the boiling process begins. Then the steam is led through tubes to the pitcher, which is located in the cool water. At this point, the steam condenses and is accumulated into the pitcher. In this method, the distillation process takes up to 7 hours. Keep in mind that the pitcher must be in cool water to facilitate and expedite the condensation process. In the industrial factory, we have sophisticated machinery that is voluminous and produce a large amount of rose water in a short time. The process begins from a giant pool where its water is led to the heating room. At this department, the water turns into a steam and is led into the tubes that are connected to the colossal pots, which can take up to a ton of flowers plus water, and the steam is heating them. Then the essence of flowers is extracted, and after distillation procedures, the rose water is led to the steel tank. At this point, the pasteurization process begins and the rose water is heated up to 80 degrees Celsius and is passed through filters and in the end is accumulated in big tanks. Then the rose water is ready to be poured into bottles and sealed. Then they are transported to the stores for sale. Thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed this episode. Let me know your opinion in the comment section, and if you like, please subscribe to my channel and wait for new videos.